changing ways in so-called liberated days. A story comes to mind of a friend of mine. Georgie boy, he's gay, I guess. Nothing more, nothing less. The kindest guy I ever knew. His mother's tears fell in vain the afternoon George tried to explain that he needed love like all the rest. Cara said there must be a mistake. How can my son not be straight after all I've said and done for him? Cast out by the ones he loves, a victim of these gay days, it seems. Oh, Georgie went to New York town, where he quickly settled down and soon became the fawn of the great wide way. Accepted by Manhattan's elite, all the places that were chic, no party was complete without George. Along the boulevards he'd cruise, and all the old queens blew him cues. Everybody loved George Boy. Was in the summer '75. Said he was in love. I said I'm pleased. George attended the opening night of another Broadway hype that split before the final curtain thing. Deciding to take a shortcut home, on and on he meant no wrong. A gentle breeze blew down Fifth Avenue. Just one aim to roll some innocent passerby. There ensued a fearful fight. Screams rang out at the night. George's head in a bifold cornerstone. A leather kid, a switchblade knife, who did not intend to take his life. He just pushed his luck a little too far that night. When the sight of blood dispersed the gang, a crowd gathered. Police came, an ambulance screamed to a halt on 53rd and 3rd. This place, George's life ended there, but I ask who really cares? George once said to me, and I quote, he said, youth's a mask, but it don't last. Live it long and live it fast. Georgie was a friend of mine. Hey, Georgie, what do you know? Thank you.
take my life.